Welcome to the presentation of MDA 8.6.1. My name is Matthias Gekeler. At ITAS, I am the product manager for MDA. The new features listed here will be part of my presentation. Below the video, you can find jump marks which will guide you directly to a topic. First, I'd like to demonstrate an enhancement of the import functionality. Already since a former version, an MDA 8 configuration in the XDX format can be selected for the import. With version 8.6.1, it is new that contents like files, layers and instruments are offered in the import dialog as well. The checkboxes allow to define easily all objects to be imported. When importing a file, this is exactly the same as adding it to the configuration. When layers and instruments are imported, the result is identical with a copy and paste operation in the configuration manager. In my opinion, the handling and selection in the import dialog is clearer and more comfortable. Moreover, an additional use case gets better supported. Imagine you have created a configuration based on one measure file. Now you would like to see the same set of signals but from a second measure file. This can be done in the following manner. First, create a copy of the configuration in which all selected signals derive from one file only. Next, you continue in your configuration by adding the new measure file, which I did already, and by removing the original file. Then you start the import of the copied configuration. Here it is important to deselect the files. Since all signals of the imported objects reference to one measure file only and the target configuration contains exactly one file, MDA tries to map the imported signals automatically to the new file. The rules applied for the mapping are the same as used when a file replacement is done. If your configuration contains calculated signals, it is important to rename these before the import process is started. If needed, MDA will rename the calculated signals during the import, but the imported instruments keep the reference to the original signal names. As a result, the wrong calculated signals will be shown. If you missed the renaming step, as I did, just use the undo functionality. Then you can rename the calculated signals. Afterwards, conduct the import again. Select the copied configuration and deselect the files for the import. This procedure can be repeated for further measure files. As a last step, you only need to add the removed files again, whereby MDA proposes automatically a replacement of the formerly removed measure files. Eventually, you end up with a configuration which has for multiple files the same sets of signals displayed in comparable instruments. Next, I want to demonstrate how the user is informed when something unusual happens. Especially when an import is done, there can happen different situations which might be relevant for the user. But not every of these situations has a direct impact for the user's work. Therefore, MDA shows just a highlighted entry in the status bar, and you can continue with your work. Only when you click on the status bar entry, a new docking window opens called Notifications. There, more information is given. Moreover, all former messages are shown. By means of the Clear All button, all entries can be removed. An often requested improvement relates to the definition of time offsets. Basically, MDA 8 allowed, already for several versions, to define time offsets for files or individual signals. However, This required several steps, and the offset value had to be entered manually. Overall, this was not really convenient. With MDA 8.6.1, defining offsets is much faster and easier. You select the signal in the oscilloscope. While you press the Shift key, you drag the signal curve with the mouse to its desired position. After releasing the mouse, you need to confirm the time shift operation. This is done to prevent an unintended shifting. With your confirmation, the time offset is applied to the whole measure file. Accordingly, the time basis of all signals of the respective file is changed. As a result, the shift can be seen in all instruments, it affects calculated signals, and it defines the timeline for a measure file export. By zooming in more deeply and performing another shift operation, the time offset can be defined more precisely. In case you want to shift a signal individually, you need to create a calculated signal first. Subsequently, you add the calculated signal to an oscilloscope and shift it. The offset value is shown in the output options of the calculated signal. Possibly, you might want to replace the original signal by the shifted one. This can be done in the Configuration Manager. Select an instance of the original signal. Use the Replace option in the context menu and define to conduct the replacement everywhere. In the present version of MDA, you still need to correct manually the formula of the shifted calculated signal. This behavior will be improved in an upcoming MDA version. The following enhancement is about merging measure files. Let's assume you have recorded several measure files in Inca. Each file includes the same set of signals. Now you would like to combine the separate files into one as if it was just one recording. This can be done with the command line tool mdfcombine.exe. It is installed together with MDA 8. The former versions of the tool provided already an option called Merge. Then the separate measure files are combined chronologically. But merging fails if your files have overlapping time ranges or if a clear file recording time is missing. Since MDA 8.6.1, for such cases, or if you wish to define a specific file order, a new combine option is available. It is named Append. In my example, you see some signals from three different measure files. Each file starts with a first timestamp of about zero, as it is the case for separate recordings. The tool mdfcombine.exe can be found in a subfolder of the MDA installation. It can be operated, for example, in a DOS console. Using the argument help lists all arguments, their meanings, and the available options. At the end, some examples are given. For my files, I want to define the order how the source files are combined. Accordingly, I use for the argument combination the option append. Moreover, there shall be a gap of 1 second at the conjunction points. To do so, I use the argument fixed gap with a value of 1 billion nanoseconds. To avoid entering lengthy file paths in the DOS console, I personally prefer to define sources and destination in an .ini file. It is used by the argument -i and its path information. The newly created combined file can be added to MDA as usual. It includes a single set of the combined signals. Additionally, there is a new enumeration signal named File. It lists the time ranges and the names of the source files. Besides the mentioned case of separate recordings, there exists another source for getting multiple comparable files. These can originate from the export of relevant time ranges from a larger measurement file. When using the time offset feature, your extract files will also start at about zero. Again, you can use the tool MDF Combine and the new Append option. Accordingly, you get one file which includes just the relevant time ranges you have formerly exported. Please note, with MDA 8.6.1, you should timeshift the exported files before you combine them. With the next version of MDF Combine in MDA 8.6.2, this is not needed anymore. Besides the already demonstrated enhancements, there were some usability improvements done. First, I can mention the possibility to show or hide the columns in the signal list of the oscilloscope. As in the Windows Explorer, you can open by a right-click on the header a drop-down which lists the column names. A second improvement in the oscilloscope is the behavior of the insert key. Now the active strip is used for a newly added signal. Of course, this is done only if the active strip supports the selected signal. Else, the default behavior is applied, like a new separate strip at the bottom for any Boolean signal. And last, I'd like to mention that the overview of the shortcuts is no longer a modal dialog. This means the window does not block your work in MDA anymore. So you can position the overview list, for example, on a second screen, and whenever you want to learn a new shortcut, just have a look. My last topic is about a general enhancement. Typically, measure files are stored on a local disk or a network share. Alternatively, files can be organized in a database. MDA 8.6.1 is now prepared to connect to databases according to SMODS standard. The standard defines the interfaces and general structure of such a database, but it also allows some degree of freedom for the concrete configuration of the database. Therefore, ETAS cannot provide a uniform product solution. Rather, the actual setup of a specific database must be considered. Please contact an ETAS representative in case you are interested to access your ASAM-ODS database directly from MDA 8. Here you see an overview of all features of MDA 8.6.1. More details are given in the What's New slides. You can find these, as well as other documentation materials, in the MDA itself and in the ETAS Download Center. Thank you for your attention and for using MDA 8.